Starship SN15 is a benchmark Starship that has significant design and implementation upgrades compared to its predecessors. The world cannot wait for SN15 to go up, belly flop, flip, soft land, and, well, not explode. Make sure you watch until the end of the video because today we tell you recent updates about the Starship SN15 static fire test and when it might launch. SpaceX conducted a pre-launch static fire test for Starship SN15. The upgraded Starship prototype serial number 15, outfitted with hundreds of improvements, fired up its three Raptor engines for a few seconds, while the craft remained anchored to the ground at SpaceX's South Texas site at around 5 p.m. CDT on Monday, April 26. The test was one of the most smoothest static fire tests so far. The rocket's engine seemed to perform nominally, and SpaceX ultimately closed out the evening's testings a few hours early. The sound of the exhaust sounded a little different. Around the same time as SN15's first static fire attempt was wrapping up, SpaceX distributed safety notices to Boca Chica Village residents, indicating that a second static fire test may be planned on Tuesday. Musk didn't mention plans for a second static fire, but he tweeted, "Starship SN15 static fire completed, preparing for flight later this week." So, SN15 won't remain groundbound for long. Today's static fire was a key checkout ahead of a high-altitude test flight, which will take the vehicle about 6.2 miles, 10 kilometers, into the Texas sky soon, very likely to be sometime later this week, within Friday, the 30th of April. SN15 will be the fifth Starship prototype to attempt this flight in less than 5 months. Like all the previous four other high-altitude flight tests before it, Starship SN15 will be doing a similar 10 to 12 kilometer hop test, and it will attempt to perform a complete ascent, controlled belly flop, landing flip maneuver, and soft touchdown. Starship SN8 through SN11 tried and could not survive with the rocket intact, though prototype SN10 did manage to survive for around 10 minutes on the ground before its still hard landing led to an eventual explosion. All the previous four failures ultimately had different causes. Starship SN8 lost fuel tank pressure, starving its Raptors and causing a near total loss of thrust seconds before touchdown. One of SN9's Raptors failed to ignite for a landing burn, triggering an even more aggressive impact with the ground. Starship SN10 landed in one piece, but its lone landing engine underperformed when it began to ingest helium-ullage gas, a quick fix implemented after SN8's pressurization issue. SN11 exploded almost immediately after attempting to ignite its three engines for landing, failing even earlier than its predecessors. In all four flight tests, the respective Starship prototypes narrowly missed a fully successful and survivable landing, but it provided SpaceX a great deal of data and direct experience to improve the rocket's design and operations with. Two of the four failures, SN9 and SN11, appear to have been the fault of one or more of Starship's three Raptor engines. Moving on from those initial series of tests with SN8 through SN11, SN15 is the first vehicle to sport improvements ranging from the thrust pug to her avionics, and more importantly to an upgraded iteration of the next-generation Raptor engines. Other improvements have not been revealed, although may include the header tank system, which in total would form a mitigation path to the issue suffered by previous Starship prototypes. This raises hopes that whatever changes the company has implemented will substantially improve reliability and thus the odds of a successful high-altitude launch and landing test. After the SN11 explosion, work on the Starship SN15 was intensified in an apparent attempt to meet Musk's stated deadline of a few days to roll the rocket to the launch pad. Not long after, on April 8th, Starship prototype SN15 was moved to the launch site. SN15 passed the pressure test with room temperature nitrogen the next day, on March 30th, 2021. The same day as Starship SN11's foggy, ill-fated launch debut, Musk announced that the SN15 will include hundreds of design improvements across structures, avionics, software, and engine. SpaceX accelerated work on its latest Starship prototype, SN15, almost immediately after the mid-air explosion of Starship SN11. 3 days later, on April 12th, SpaceX performed a cryogenic test on the main tank, and a day later, the header tanks underwent the same process. An Elon Musk tweet on April the 15th read, "Aiming to launch next week." As of April 26th, and in spite of 1 or 2 weeks of delays, the fact that Starship SN15 managed to complete a 3-Raptor static fire test on its first true attempt is a great sign that the rocket's many hundreds of improvements, as told by Elon, may already be paying dividends. A launch later this week would make the effects of those improvements even harder to deny. A successful launch and landing in the next few days would all but guarantee that SpaceX's process of iterative development is working like a charm. Regardless of whether SN15 survives its first flight, Starship SN16 will likely be ready to take over a matter of days later. If you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video on Starship SN15 upgrades that is shown in the end screen. See you there.